want free life and I want fresh air. And I sigh for the canter after the cattle. The crack of whips like shots in a battle. The melee of horns and hoofs and heads that roars and wrangles and scatters and spreads. The green beneath and the blue above. And dash and danger and life and love and Lasca. Lasca used to ride on a mouse-gray Mustang close to my side. Little knew she of books or creeds, an Ave Maria sufficed her need. Little she cared, save to be by my side, to ride with me and ever to ride, from San Saba's shore to La Vaca's tide. She was bold as the billows that beat, she was as wild as the breezes that blow. From her little head to her little feet, she was swayed in her suppleness to and fro by each gust of passion. A sapling pine that grows on the edge of a Kansas bluff and wars with the wind when the weather is rough is like this Lasca, this love of mine. She would hunger that I might eat, would take the bitter and leave me the sweet. But once when I'd made her jealous for fun, at something I'd whispered or looked or done, she drew from her breast a dear little dagger, and sting of a wasp, it made me stagger. An inch to the left or an inch to the right, and I shouldn't be maundering here tonight. But scratches don't count in Texas down by the Rio Grande. The air was heavy, the night was hot. I sat by her side and forgot the herd that were taking their rest, forgot that the air was close abreast, that the Texas norther comes sudden and soon in the dead of night or the blaze of noon, that once let the herd at its breath take fright, nothing on earth can stop the flight. And woe to the rider and woe to the steed who falls in front of their mad stampede. Was that thunder? I sprang to the saddle and she clung behind, away on a hot chase down the wind, for we rode for our lives. The Mustang flew and we urged him on. There was one chance left and you have but one. Halt, jump to the ground and shoot your horse. Crouch under his carcass and take your chance. And if the steers in their frantic course don't batter you both to pieces at once, you may thank your star. If not, goodbye to the quickening kiss and the long-drawn sigh and the open air and the open sky in Texas down by the Rio Grande. The cattle gained on us, and just as I felt for my old six-shooter behind in my belt, down came the Mustang and down came we, clinging together. What was the rest? A body that spread itself on my breast, two arms that shielded my dizzy head, two lips that hard on my lips were pressed. Then came thunder in my ears as over a surge the sea of steers, blows that beat blood into my eyes. And when I could rise, Lasca was dead. I gouged out a grave a few feet deep, and there in earth's arms I laid her to sleep. For many a day the flowers have spread a pall of petals over her head, and the little gray hawk hangs aloft in the air, and the sly coyote trots here and there, and the black snake glides and glitters and slides into a rift in a cottonwood tree, and the buzzard sails on and comes and is gone, stately and still like a ship at sea. And I wonder why I do not care for the things that are like the things that were. Does half my heart lie buried there in Texas, down by the Rio Grande?